Let me ask you, John Adams said, and I want both of you to respond to this.
Okay.
John Adams said the Constitution was made to govern a moral and righteous people. Are the races in America equally moral and righteous, and would addressing immorality within these groups help the gun violence?
I mean, every group in America is going...
John right, though, about the righteous, and John Adams right about the righteous and moral people.
Sure.
He's right about that.
That we need a righteous people to govern?
Right. We need
given that we have a democracy and our...
He said that the Constitution was made to govern a moral and righteous people. Was he right about that?
Probably, yeah.
You're not sure?
I'm pretty sure democracy needs a righteous people to, otherwise they would vote for horrible things, right?
What do you say about that?
Yeah, I mean, I would agree with John Adams' statement there.
And are the races in America equally moral and righteous, and would addressing those issues within these groups maybe end this violence that they are having?
I don't think any two racial groups in America are equal to one another, because their histories are very different from one another. And then addressing moral
and
problems
as well.
Yeah, we can get to that, I guess. But I mean, addressing moral issues, I mean, yeah, you can do that to some extent.
Would that make a difference, though?
I mean, like, it depends on what you mean by address moral issues. Typically, just telling people to act better doesn't usually do much. You usually have to, you know, go a little bit farther with it. So, you know, like James suggested, greater representation in media can be a way to do that. You know, different types of programs, like after-school programs, stuff related to that can help people, give people role models.
That's not going to help, though. The blacks have... midnight basketball. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Midnight basketball is not working. They go down on the court now and kill each other.
Yeah, no, in Chicago, there was just a story recently. It was very, very concerning to me. Yeah, I'm from Chicago originally. And they were shooting up the funeral of the of the gang member who got shot by them. They went and shot the funeral up.
Isn't that funny?
Isn't it?
Not really, that's pretty sad. Do you feel like you're biologically predisposed to commit criminal activities, you or your family?
What does that mean?
Well, so James suggested that maybe biologically you might have an inclination as a black person to be more violent than a white person.
We didn't then, but I believe they do now.
That evolved in one generation? All the genes
changed? No, that's not what I said. I said that there's biological aspects that certainly lead to people committing more crime. So there was a Harvard study on, for instance, and we're talking about on average here. There was a Harvard study.
Not me.
Right, not no, just me, not just, well, we can look at the Rushton Jensen study. Yeah. The Rushton Jensen study said that, and even, you know, academics agree that a lower average IQ makes you more predisposed to commit crime. We look at the Port Arthur massacre shooter. He had a 70 IQ. Would you agree that a lower average IQ makes you more predisposed to commit crime?
I don't know if that's true offhand, but I could believe that, sure.
Yeah, Rushton Jensen study. So if we look at the 100 years of IQ data that we have, that we have this data, 100 years of IQ testing, we'll see a difference in the average IQ of black Americans, average IQ of white Americans, average IQ of Hispanic Americans, average IQ of Asian Americans, with Asians at the very top. And so I think that we can find a correlation there. It might not be a direct correlation of why Asians commit like almost no crimes, or East Asians, and why they have the highest SAT scores, and they're suing Harvard right now because of affirmative action. I would say that there's some correlation that we can talk about there without being called racist, you know, and all these different things. I think we can talk about those things.
Well, the problem is you weren't talking about a correlation. You were talking about a causal effect of your race impacting
your IQ. Well, I'm not saying, no. What I'm saying is we look at the homicide rate, the weapons violation rate per 100,000. The homicide rate's the same rankings. Black Americans, 130 per 100,000. Hispanics, 42 per 100,000. Whites, 23 per 100,000. This is according to FBI data. And Asians are like not even on a chart. They don't even register on the chart. So I'm saying if we look at these things, you go to thegreatschools.org, and because I have three children, and you know, I look for schools when we were buying our house, and you go to greatschools.org, and if you go to the richest area, the richest district, or the poorest district, and you're always going to see those same rankings. And when they talk about like the Rushton Jensen study, you look at James D. Watson, who discovered the DNA was the double helix, he talked about this a lot. And you can find some sort of correlation that we're not allowed to talk about that for some reason nowadays.
Well, we're allowed to talk about correlations. You keep saying this word correlation, but what you were talking about was a causal link.
Well, is that not biological? What I'm saying is No, is
not
IQ
necessarily.
Biological?
Not necessarily.
Well, they say that up until 18, it is.
Well, who IQ do you believe is the highest, black or white?
Right now in the United States, probably white people.
And why is that?
Greater access to wealth, greater access to education. We
That's
have a
not yet.
Far different.
No.
Do you think it's because of the genes?
I think it's because of. Well, that's a good question.
Well, I mean, we all evolved on different continents.
I think because of,
How can you say if we all evolved on different continents that there's not biological difference? I mean, look, you're not going to see many Asians going in the NBA, and there's a reason for that. It's because of physical differences. Black Americans are more athletic, inherently, biologically. No one disputes that. If we
there
all,
are plenty of people that dispute a lot of these things. These are it is very hard to tease out a biological causal relationship between somebody's genes and a highly polygenetic trait like IQ.
Well,
I understand the desire.
You're disputing the person who discovered that DNA was
who's been largely also discredited by the entire academic community.
Well,
there are
hundreds
of geneticists that have signed on to these really broad letters saying that they're very uncomfortable.
Rushton Jensen.
With the,
Richard Herrnstein, Charles Murray, the guy who discovered DNA effectively, he discovered DNA was
so
a double
these
helix.
People are all making, first of all, Charles Murray has no background in biology
years of IQ
whatsoever.
Data.
Yeah,
100
IQ
years
data,
of IQ.
Yeah, but hold on, IQ data, well, hold on. IQ data doesn't necessarily mean there's a causal relationship. Like, you keep pointing out how good Asian Americans are compared to black Americans without even thinking for a second, well, the history of these two people in this country is incredibly different. Black people were brought over 200, 250 years ago on slave ships against their will from their homes to the United States to live here under slavery. And then under legalized segregation, and now for the past 60, 70 years, we're kind of starting to right the ship. Asian Americans, a lot of them largely.
Why was the family structure better under Jim Crow?
This is a single question. Asian Americans largely immigrate over here because they have the money to do so from China or other countries. And
how do you explain that blacks were smarter
than I'm just saying there's massive.
Under the Jim Crow law than they are today. How do you explain that?
It's a very complicated question. It's
That's not complicated.
So you
how
think it's just because of
well, London didn't have London didn't have Jim Crow. London didn't have Jim Crow laws.
I mean,
why
like,
are,
if
why
you're
black
if you're if
the, stabbing
I can only
si-
I can
there.
Only side with the majority of the academic community that is incredibly uncomfortable making the assertion that biology is the reason why certain groups of people are more violent than other groups
yeah,
of people.
Yeah, and that academic community is the same academic community that got Brown University to delete a study on rapid onset gender dysphoria because it might hurt someone's feelings. Okay, this is the same academic community that props up gender dysphoria as something cool to be nowadays,
I don't
completely
think
denying science. This is
okay,
a science
well,
denial.
No. If first
that
of all,
there are biological differences between men and women. You have people
so, firstly,
who are on your side
when
of the
you
aisle
talk about,
who walk
firstly,
off the stage.
Okay, so firstly, if we want to deny academic research or academic literature, we can only engage in conspiracy theory, which is something I'm not interested in doing. I can only go by what the literature says. Secondly, if you want to talk about science
and
denial.
I can only go by what the literature
sure,
says.
Sure, and
well.
If you want to go by science denial, I mean, the APA has made pretty clear statements regarding transgender individuals or gender dysphoria. These aren't fantastical things. They might make conservatives uncomfortable, but just because it makes you uncomfortable doesn't mean the science isn't
the
real.
The APA, once within their study on gender dysphoria, said it was a mental condition.
Gender dysphoria is considered a mental condition.
So why are we propping up a mental condition?
We don't prop up a mental condition.
Why
we try
are we
to alleviate.
Not trying to help these
we
people
do
with
try to
the
help them.
Suicide rates
we do try
and
to help
say
them.
That it's okay to
we do try to help them. And the number one way that the APA suggests to alleviate gender dysphoria is through things like hormone therapy and sex reassignment surgery.
I would say that that's probably not the best. There's mothers who are crying.
I can only point to what the literature says because
they're coming home with their breasts chopped off and their ovaries
removed.
So
nobody chops off their breasts randomly, and that's not how sex reassignment surgery
daughters are coming home.
They don't. It's not happening. This is
fantastical.
I gotta
ask this
is
because we're
absolutely happening. These are mothers who have told their story.
We'll have you guys back about this.